Liberty Fighters Network.
Good day, liberators and fellow South Africans. I regret that I hadn't made this video a long time ago. I do note that there's a big urgency for people to know what an agent, a operative, and a spy is. Unfortunately, Hollywood has romanticized agents. I'm just going to refer to all of them as just agents, and I will get to the nitty-gritty of what function each and every one of them actually has got. But Hollywood has romanticized the industry of agents, with James Bond and Ethan Grant, and apparently they've got all these nice gadgets that they use for whatever they supposedly do. Nice cars that's changed into these nice machines. And but in reality, agents are very normal and very, very nice people. They must be nice because they need to attract people to them. And so for that purpose, they infiltrate organizations like Liberty Fighters Network, but that is not possible because I always stay in control of Liberty Fighters Network. I truly believe that Liberty Fighters Network is one organization which cannot be infiltrated. There were a lot of attempts, and because I know how agents function and how they operate, I can quickly and easily identify a potential threat. Because I have been introduced to the world of, or have been made contact with the world of espionage quite at a very, very early time in my life. I think I was about 22 years old. At that point in time, I was as many of our followers would know, that I started out as a dynamic politician. I joined the ANC. I was a secretary branch of the Sunnyside branch of the ANC, and with a lot of influential people, Thabo Mbeki, Stanley Sangweni, Mohamed Titi, and also Mohamed Sidat, Tony Sidat. He was the director of international affairs in the Department of National Security, State Security Agency. With what was shared with me, how they operate, etc., etc. And at that point in time, according to Tony, it was not necessary for agents anymore because agents were only necessary to overcome the old regime. So at that point in time, according to Tony, agents' work were actually moot. There wasn't actually many agents left, and that is in some way that is totally correct. Many of these agents who were doing their work in the old regime, they didn't have any work. As I said, that Hollywood has misguided people with understanding how agents operate. It's not an agent. The actual agent is not the one who says that he or she is an agent. It's actually the ones who are not saying that they are agents, who are truly agents. And you will find that these guys and girls are many times very hermit type of people. They don't have family. They don't have friends. They just infiltrate wherever they go. And unfortunately, many of these agents have, since the new democracy, they became rogue. They became lone rangers, and they wanted to do work, but they actually created their own system in many respects. And the system is all about getting as much as possible information. Information is power. Information is a commodity that you can really trade. So if you can get as much as possible information about a person or an organization, and you can then sell that information to someone else who is in competition or wants information about that person, that is where they come in. And agents are not loyal at all. They will come to you and make as if they are your best friend. And then eventually they will just use that opportunity to suck as much as possible information out of you to so that they can just eventually sell it off to your enemy. So you will, Liberty Fighters Network has been attempted to be infiltrated many times before. And luckily, because of the experience that I've gained over the years, I can smell an agent from a mile off. I know exactly who is. They might think that I don't know, but it's there's just this sixth sense that one has got working all the time with agents, that one eventually actually realize who are agents in your network and who are trying to get information. And the key thing is that you must never allow them to get dirt on you. That is what they're after, because getting dirt on you, they can then extort you, they can intimidate you, they can coerce you in doing things for them. And that is what agents are actually doing. And it's not actually that they are working for a specific government. How many times have you heard about double agents or triple agents? Yes, they do exist. And it, as I say, that it's not the ones that say that they are agents. It's those who don't say that they are agents who are actually the real agents. They don't have code names. They don't have gadgets. They just simply go on a journey to collect as much as possible information, and that is what their commodity is, as I've said. So just for the record, I eventually, well, I was, I think, in about 2020, I was in the ANC for approximately two, three years. So about 2002, I left the ANC because of racism against me. So I've just said, well, there was an incident that happened, and I realized that there wasn't place for me as a white person at that point in time in the ANC. Because if you are a member of the ANC and you doing all this great work for them, and at the end of the day they literally telling you, sorry, you cannot have this position because we want a black person in that position, although I was the best. So I just realized, okay, I couldn't go on, but leave it as it may, just for the record that I've said that. Then I came in contact with the two sides of the agent work. In one sense, they are basically part of the criminal system out there, literally. They're part of the mafias. The mafia will call them the mafia, but at the end of the day, it's all about agent work. They infiltrate these criminal networks, and they're doing as much as possible crime so that they can get power, they can assist people getting power in the criminal network. And then they eventually, you also get the other side where they are literally extorting and intimidating the criminals, and they're getting paid for that. So they're getting information about criminals, and then these agents go out and they say, well, I've got this dirt on you. I can work for you as well, but you pay me a decent salary or income whenever I need it, or there's another favor that you need to render to me. So roughly in 2006, 2007, I got involved with a very prominent, well-known agent. Kevin Tritzman was his name. And at that point in time, I was working for Louis Liebenberg. And Kevin Tritzman was actually interested in exposing Louis Liebenberg for his well-for-you so-called pyramid scheme that he ran at that point in time. But in any event, now after Louis Liebenberg tried to come back, he wanted to get rid of me. He got his Lebanese arm breakers to go after me. I, in fact, actually got hold of, I knew someone who knew Kevin Tritzman, and Kevin Tritzman was a very good friend of this person that I knew, and Kevin Tritzman said, okay, but I want you to provide me with information so that I can get back at Louis and ensure that he repays the people their monies. And at that point in time, I've provided him with a lot of information. But as it turned out, apparently, as I understood, with all the information, he actually went to Louis Liebenberg and made some deal with him. Apparently, Kevin was able to get contracts with AlexCorp and could have helped Louis Liebenberg. And then I, one evening, I was drinking that time. So when I was very arrogant and I phoned Louis Liebenberg and I said to him, it was actually SMS that I've sent to him. Oh, do you like Kevin Tridesman opening doors for you? Blah. So I was drunk at that stage, and it was about 10 minutes later or so when Kevin phoned me and he said, you know what is good for you, Reyno? You don't screw around with people like us. And I can eliminate you very quickly. You're not a threat to me. And I was literally weeing in my pants at that point in time. So I got directly involved in agent work and espionage at that point in time. Kevin Tridesman was later on killed by someone else that was in his network. And that guy who killed him was an attorney, George Michalidis, I believe. And George Michalidis was an attorney that Kevin was supposed to do work for. There was money, something like 30, 38 million rand or something, that was paid into George Michalidis' trust account, which belonged to this Kevin Tridesman, of some transaction that he did. And then George Michalidis shot him with someone's pistol. And so Kevin Tridesman was a very good example of live by the sword, you'll die by the sword. But to make things come to the point is that Kevin Tridesman was an agent during the old regime already. So he was also in the Truth and Reconciliation Commission that he testified there, and of his operations of some sort. And there I've learned that agents can be good and they can be bad. They are very neutral in many respects. They thrive on information. So a very key thing, that if you don't want to be infiltrated or fell target to these or fall victim to agent work, there are a couple of things that I live by. And because I live by this these principles, it is almost impossible for agents to actually get hold of me at the end of the day. Because the first important thing is that, yes, believe in God. I think that my faith actually helps me a lot in what I'm doing. That's very important. You must have respect for your God, Jesus Christ, in my circumstances. A second important thing is that don't drink and don't do drugs. The moment when you drink and get intoxicated in some way, you are opening yourself to be infiltrated by agents. It's very easy for them then to get hold of you, extort you, and they get information from you, definitely, if you have a problem with that. Then a third thing is that don't go out to places where you can get in trouble. Make sure that if you go to a place that people know where you are going to, they can follow you if necessary, and don't go to places like pubs, where to a bar, and sit there until 2 o'clock in the morning. When you get out there, they are waiting for you outside, and they can get hold of you if they really want to. Fourth thing, most probably it's very important, almost like the first one, is to have a good family life, to be faithful to your partner, to your wife. Because the moment when you might go out and knyp die kat in die donker, most probably those women have been set up for you as a trap to fall in. They have been put in your path, or that knock shop that you're visiting have been infiltrated already by agents, and they're literally paying those girls to either get you into trouble of being unfaithful, and they can take photographs of you when doing that, or they can manipulate them in such a way so that, or they can manipulate you in giving more information, because it's so very, you feel so relaxed when these girls are around you, and then you open yourself to spill the beans and to actually rely or confide in them. So you are actually telling very important secrets to them. That is a way. And then also in the same sense, do not go and visit websites which can get you in trouble. So if you're someone who might go onto porn sites, or even worse, crime sites, or the black net, child pornography, etc., etc., you are a target. There are traces on those websites who know exactly where you are and who you are, and they can use the fact that you are visiting those sites also to intimidate and to entrap you at the end of the day. If you want to do the work that I'm doing, don't go that route. I would say, keep vigilant. You don't confide in people even if you think those people can be trusted. With special work that you are doing, don't just go and blabber everything out. And in some ways, your communication might be intercepted by these guys, because many of them are very good IT literate, and they can get all of your emails and your communication that you've actually received. So they can use that at the end of the day against you. So I always say that, I know for a fact that my communication have been infiltrated a couple of times, and still is most probably. But I must be one of the most boring people to follow, because of the fact that, I don't have anything to hide. So they can get as much as possible information from me, but they will not find any dirt on me. And I'm prepared. I'm not going to make any changes to that. This is a formula that works, and I'm keeping to it. So if you want to do the work that I am doing, then these are the elements that you need to look at for keep on doing what you're doing. And then the last thing before I forgot, the fact that I am very knowledgeable with the law and attend court myself and know how to litigate and even defend myself in criminal cases, that is so important, because when you are being pursued or trapped in a certain situation, then you know how to get out and how to pursue that. So that is a very important thing that I've learned, how to counter all these espionages that currently is happening in our community, in our world today. And then I just want to emphasize something very important. Although they don't have gadgets, as James Bond and Ethan Grant, to name but only two, always have. There has been a big commotion over the CCTV surveillancing over the past couple of years, and the installation of these cameras in key cities, Durban, elsewhere. The technology has been there since for decades already. I was involved in 2002. 2001, 2002, I was personally involved in the Sunnyside City Improvement District in Eston Street. I think it's now Modiba Street or something like that. But in 2001, Eston Street was the project for the CCTV anti-crime project. And Sunnyside was then chosen, or Eston Street was chosen as the model, or the first of the installation of all these cameras. And when that system was connected today, and there was a big party celebrations at that point in time, the mayor was there and other celebrities, and I saw with my own eyes, and I've experienced this, that based on 2001, so that is about 23 years ago already, by just taking a photograph of the set manager at that point, Gerard was his name. The photo was taken of his face, He was told that he can go anywhere in Esslingen Street where these cameras are. And after 15 minutes, after half an hour, they've scanned in his photo. And within seconds, they found him on the cameras by face recognition. That was 23 years ago. So that technology has been with us for many, many years, and even before 2001. So my question always is that if that technology is there, why isn't it being used against prevention of crime? So it either does not work, or it does work, but it's for other purposes. And those other purposes are actually to get information, to track criminals. Criminals are part of the industry. It's part of the capitalist system. I always say that capitalism cannot survive without an element of crime. And this is exactly that. By following these criminals, there are actually ways in which there are deals struck with these criminals to make money. That's why we've got such a big problem with crime these days, because agents have infiltrated the criminal network and the agents have eventually become the criminals themselves. That is the wonder of a war. Because where you're actually trying to utilize all the technology during that war period, when there is no war, it must be used for something else. And what has happened here is that all these agents and the technology and everything has been converted into the criminal networks in South Africa. So they are no more special agents, 007 in South Africa. They're all rogue. Even during the colonial during the years of segregation, these agents were actually given by the South African National Party government, were given criminal tasks. They had to establish companies, and they had to trade and make money through those companies. And some of these agents, I'm even aware, were supposed to debt those companies for themselves when they resign or when they go on pension. And then eventually the state just comes in and says, oh, well, thank you very much for all the work that you have done, but that company is now ours. So many of these companies have been established for espionage purposes and to get information. Information is power. And eventually, we are now sitting today in this problematic situation that agents are information seekers. They're selling the information that they obtain from you to others who are your enemy. And to your enemy, they are selling information of your enemy that they've obtained. So according to me, agents have become rogue. They're not what they were supposed to. And I doubt whether they were ever actually supposed to do what they were told. I know for a fact that the ANC was a agent project. It was an operation. It was a covert operation. The establishment of Inkatha Freedom Party was a counter-terrorism project. So that is why you will, for example, for interesting sake, see that the IFP is also now against the NK Party and also with the ANC, because they were molded from the same resources at the end of the day. People, there are a lot of information that I can share with you regarding the world of espionage and secret agents. But the fact of the matter is that agents do not help us at this point in time. You cannot trust an agent. You can be made to believe that you've got this agent on your side, but that agent is just turning around and selling your information or counteracting what you try to do by helping another one at the end of the day. So unfortunately, the world of agents have become rogue and nothing more than criminal. That is sad to say, but unfortunately, one needs to be cautious all the time when you would like to reach certain goals, and you easily get sidetracked. These agents can even get people to make donations to you, nice donations, and appear as if they're supportive of what you're doing. But eventually, that is just to make you soft so that they can get information from you. or get you to say something or do something that you were not supposed to do. People, I hope that you understand the concept of how agents and espionage are actually working these days, and how these agents have literally infiltrated numerous of our organizations which were supposed to assist us, and it just went rogue. It didn't reach the goals what we expected they would. Then you'll know that they were most probably victims of espionage, of agents who literally put them on a sidetrack, and they got money. They got paid for doing that. Until the next time, Godspeed.
Liberty Fighters Network.
Liberty Fighters Network.
Liberty Fighters Network.